Discovery of viruses. In 18th century, Dmitry Ivanovsky conducted the experiments. He studied the tobacco mosaic disease. Tobacco mosaic disease found in tobacco leaves caused by TMV, tobacco mosaic virus. So while studying disease conditions, he collected the diseased plant and diseased leaves too. From that leaves, he collected the sap of diseased tobacco leaves. What is sap? Sap means juice, leaf juice. So, but what type of leaf juice it is? Already infected by TMV. Infected leaves are used for the juice. Okay, leaf juice. He collected the sap of diseased tobacco leaves. Then he filtered. He used the filters, that special type of filters are used by him. What are the special type of filters means? Generally the filter measures approximately micrometers. Micrometers means they abstract the bacteria. They do not filter the bacteria. They abstract the bacteria through their filtration. Okay, such type of filters are used in the filtration of the sap of diseased tobacco leaf. Okay, after filtration, he collect that filtrate and used for infection of healthy leaves. When he rubbed that filtrate juice, when he rubbed into the healthy leaves also gone to the disease, that is mosaic disease. Okay, what he observed, even though microfiltration also, some agents are causing the disease onto the healthy plants. What are that? So he concluded that they are infectious agents. Also concluded that they are filterable agents. Filterable infectious agents. It means it clearly says that less than bacteria size they have. Okay. So generally the bacteria size in micrometers. But when you are coming to here, less than micrometer size consisting living organisms are causing the disease, especially TMV, onto the healthy leaves of tobacco. Okay, so that is concluded by the Dmitry Ivanovsky. Later, scientist Beijerinck continues the Ivanovsky experiments. So during his experiments, he collected again the sap and he conducted again repeated experiments, and also he concluded that what are the juice, what are the sap causing the disease. He has given that particular name, that is contagium vivum fluidum. Contagium vivum fluidum is the juice that is cause for the disease. That's why it is said as contagious living fluid. Contagious living fluid, nothing but of contagium vivum fluidum. Contagium vivum fluidum. So the concept is given by Beijerinck. So clearly noted, so the viruses are small particles than bacterium and they are causing the diseases on the plant of tobacco. Next, in the year 1935, W.M. Stanley purified the sap and announced that the viruses causing the mosaic disease in tobacco, they are crystallized also. It means TMV particles are crystallized by the scientist W.M. Stanley in the year 1935. Later, Frankel contract confined that what is the genetic material inside of the virus. That clearly given by the scientist. Who is he? Conrad. So he said that the virus is rich of RNA. The virus is composed of, the virus consists nucleic acid, that is RNA. Okay, so X-ray crystallography, ultra centrifugation techniques are utilized for determination of genetic material of tobacco mosaic virus, that is RNA. Okay, so like these are the successive experiments conducted by the different scientists for their contribution to the virology. What is virology? Virology is nothing but a scientific study of viruses. Okay, where the viruses are present? Viruses are present in everywhere. So they are biological entities. Okay, then you come to the classification of viruses. How they are classified? How they are classified means, according to International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, that is ICTV, ICTV, International Committee of Taxonomy of Viruses, International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses. So they given the classification and the nomenclature procedures. According to them, three hierarchical levels. One is family, another one is genus, another one is species. Family, genus, species. For example, you take the virus, AIDS virus, is acquired immunodeficiency virus, that is HIV virus. How do you give the name? According to ICTV. Okay, it belongs to the family Retroviridae. Retroviridae. Family Retroviridae. Genus Lentivirus. Lentivirus. And species Human Immune Deficiency Virus. Species Human Immune Deficiency Virus. So the nomenclature of the viruses according to the ICTV, International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, they have three hierarchical stages. One is family, genus, species. So for example, you take the HIV. HIV is cause the disease acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, that is AIDS. So how the HIV name is derived, how it is classified means, it belongs to the family, that is Retroviridae, genus Lentivirus, species Human Immune Deficiency Virus. Like the classification and nomenclature has been taken. Next, structure of viruses. Before going to the structure of viruses, I want to tell the type of viruses also. How many types of viruses are there? So generally, the viruses are biological entities. They can infect any type of living organisms. For example, they infect the plants. Virus infects the plants. Virus which are infect the plants, they are called as a plant viruses. Also called as plant viruses, phytophages. Phytophages. So if the virus infects the animal, so they are called animal viruses, also called zoophages. Animal viruses or zoophages. They infect the fungi. Mycoviruses are mycophages. Okay, mycophages. Cynophages. Cynophages means viruses which infect the cyanobacteria. Next, bacteriophages. Bacteriophages means the virus live on the bacteria. Okay, like different types of the viruses are found according to their infection, according to their host. Okay, so come to the structure of the viruses. What is the structure of virus? So when you come to the size wise, they shown variation. It is very small and also acellular. Okay, so the virus particles are called as virion. simply we said as virion. So the size of the viruses ranges from 10 to 300 nanometers. Next, which is the smallest virus? The smallest virus is F2 bacteriophage. Can you know what is the largest virus? The virus is vaccinia virus. How we can see the viruses? Generally, microbes are, we cannot able to see, they are invisible. With the help of light microscope only they are visible, but viruses are very small compared to the bacteria. They are in size of nanometers. That's why there is a need to see special type of microscopes. What are the microscopes needed for visible of viruses? Means transmission electron microscope. Under transmission electron microscopes, the viruses are visible. Okay, next, the shape of the viruses. They show the different types of the shapes according to the names are given here. So rod shape. So TMV, tobacco mosaic virus, is best example of rod shape. Next, rectangular shape. So vaccinia virus, which is the largest virus, that is in rectangular shape. Next, polygonal shape. So adenovirus is in polygonal shape. Spherical shape, polio virus is in spherical shape. Tadpod shape, bacteriophages, T2 bacteriophages are tadpod shape.